Sue Chen Chen. Today I'm going to show you some beautiful Chinese dances. Dancing as a medium of expression started in China at the beginning of civilization. The dances of early tribal society helped to unite and keep the tribe together in their struggle to survive. The written document about dance in China can be found as early as 1000 BC. Dancing during that era was mainly performed for ritual purposes. Later on, it gradually developed into a major entertainment form for nobility. This is what we call classical Chinese dance. Classical Chinese dance dominated court entertainment until the 16th century. With the coming of the Ming Dynasty, we see the opera gradually taking over court entertainment. Subsequently, classical dance ceased to exist as an independent art form. The latter part of the 20th century, however, has seen the rebirth of the classical dance. The study of history, period painting, and the opera tradition has prompted this classical dance to reemerge as a major art form once again. Today, we're going to show you some beautiful classical Chinese dances. The first piece, called Xin Jin, is a demonstration of a choreography of the Chinese dance. It will be performed by Ms. Chen Jinxin. Here, the concentration is as important as the body movement.
Thank you.
long ribbon dance will be performed by Miss Chen Guo from mainland China. This dance draws its inspiration from the Dunhuang artworks, which originated 1500 years ago. It shows the dancing fairy flying in the sky.
Thank you.
Listening to music under the moon is another classical dance. The moon in ancient China is a creative source for poetry, music, and painting. It also represents the god of love. This dance represents a Chinese beauty wandering inside her garden, listening to the music from the other side of the wall, dreaming of the love of freedom. Besides the classical dance, China has many kinds of folk dances and minority group dances. Each of them has its typical costume and dancing style, like the Uyghur dance, Tibetan dance, Thai dance, and Korean dance, just to name a few. The next dance we're going to see, Eagle Above the Grassland, is a folk dance from Inner Mongolia. The large grassland nurses its people and gives them a strong eagle-like character. It will be performed by Mr. Liu Guoju, a national prize-winning dancer from the mainland. We hope you've enjoyed our program. Thanks for joining us. I'm Xu Qingqian. Goodbye.